Welcome back to Sugar Mama TV. I am financial planner Kanna Campbell. Now, I know I owe you guys a capsule wardrobe fashion video. I didn't give it to you last month. I promised you one per month. So my apologies. I've had a lot on my plate with IVF, with exams and assignments and staff changes at the office. But I promise you, here it is right now. And I promise you, it's going to be a really good one. Now, about 6 weeks ago, on my normal everyday Instagram account at Kanna Sass, one Sunday morning, I left the kids at home with Tom and I ventured up to Bondi Junction, Westfield. And I took you guys shopping with me. I shared with you what I tried on and what I was umming and ahhing about and what I bought. And you guys absolutely loved it. So I thought this would be the perfect opportunity to share with you what I purchased and how I'm styling it and how I'm wearing it. But more importantly, the rules and the processes that I followed before even venturing up to my local shopping center, because never, ever, ever do I want any of my consumption habits or shopping decisions to impact my financial goals or my financial well-being. And this is particularly important because Black Friday is just a few days away and there are going to be some amazing sales and discounts online. So my mantra is only buy what you love, value, use and appreciate, but follow these hacks first. Now, the first thing I did was I went through everything that I already owned. I really believe if we can't see it, we forget about it. We run the risk of potentially going and buying the same thing or a similar thing and wasting our money. So by pulling everything out of my wardrobe and my drawers, going through everything, this allowed me to see what I was missing, what I needed, what was starting to like fall apart or look tired or tatty or didn't necessarily fit me anymore or work for my lifestyle needs. So it allowed me to see what I actually really needed. But also, it was actually a pleasant surprise because there were a couple of things I had forgotten about that I owned or I hadn't worn for ages, that pieces that I really loved. It was like it was reconnecting with an old friend. It was really nice. So I highly recommend before you do anything, check what you already own, because you might find you actually don't really need anything at all. So make a list of those things as you go through this process so that you don't get distracted. The second step is to take your list and go through your diary. Have a look at the things that you've got coming up that you might need a new outfit for, or you might need a special outfit for, or you know there are going to be different dynamics of people or potentially the same dynamics of people, so you know you need a couple of different outfits to roll. Now, this is really helpful because it actually makes your life run so much more smoothly and more organized, because you know exactly what outfit you're going to wear for that event. You don't have that half hour before you're supposed to walk out the door, you know, fashion disaster where you have a mental block and can't think about what to wear and what's right. By planning and preparing what you're going to wear a couple of weeks in advance makes life run so much more smoothly, and you can start to put extra special touches in your outfit and the way that you style it and the way that you put your whole outfit together. Again, go back to your list and see what needs to be added or changed on that list so that you, when you do jump online or you head to your store, you know exactly what you need to buy and you don't get distracted. Now, the third step, whilst you've got everything out in front of you and just before you put everything away, making sure it's nicely tidied and organized, is to look at your color palette. Look at the colors you always gravitate towards, because that's what you want to focus your shopping purchase around. If you're like me that loves like neutrals, but then also loves soft, beautiful pastels, make sure everything matches harmoniously. For me, if I was to go out and buy a fluorescent orange or yellow top, it's not going to go with too many items in my wardrobe, but it's really going to clash against, you know, a lot of the accessories and handbags and so forth that I already own. So it's not going to be a great investment. Of course, that doesn't mean we have to always stick to our color palette. We can occasionally spice things up, but just make sure you do it mindfully. So be really aware of colors that you naturally gravitate towards, because this is the color palette that's going to make you feel good about yourself. And of course, if we're going to be handing over our hard-earned precious cash for an item, we want to make sure that we wear it. The fourth step is probably the most important step. If you're going to skip any of the steps, this is the last one you would even come close to skipping, and that is going through your budget. So I have been quite frugal recently. I've been saving money up because I knew I wanted to buy a few key pieces for my wardrobe. So I knew exactly how much money I could spend in total. I went through all my transactions accounts and I looked at the amount of money that I'd set aside for this very special purchase. And once I had that money, that number, that total spend that I was allowed to go out and spend that would not involve, you know, leaning on a credit card or using any form of credit whatsoever, it was money that was cash for me. I then went back to my list and worked out, well, okay, you need two tops and two dresses. Roughly, how much can you spend on each of those items so that you don't exceed your maximum allowed amount? And of course, if you do this and you find that you don't spend up to your like total budget of, say, you know, for example, $1,000, and you spend, say, only $850, make sure you take that $150 and do something with it. Don't feel obliged to go and spend it. Go and put it towards something exciting, such as investing or putting it towards some emergency savings or potentially putting it towards your next special purchase. Don't feel obliged to spend up to your maximum budget. And then the fifth step that I followed was quality. If I'm going to buy something, I would much prefer to buy something that is really well made. So when I was in the store, I looked at the quality of these items I was looking to purchase. I looked at the stitching. I looked at how secure the buttons are. Are the buttons gonna come loose? Because sometimes that can like really ruin an outfit because it's really hard to match those special buttons again. How's it going to wash? Is it an item that has to be taken to the dry cleaners all the time? If you buy a dress for say $300, but it's dry clean only and it's delicate dry clean only, that can make the cost of that dress incredibly expensive. And quite often I've put those things back on the coat hangers in the shop and walked out because it's not worth it. And that is why I've had to say goodbye to a lot of fast fashion brands because they're simply not good enough. We also want to take a responsible and respectful approach towards the environment when it comes to quality. And one of my best hacks, if you want quality but on a really tight budget, go and consider the pre-loved market. I'm often buying outfits from eBay, from high end on Facebook. There's the Real Real, the Vestiaire Collective. There's also a great local group in my area called Trading in Style, which are on Instagram, but also have a store so you can go and inspect it in person. There are so many of these amazing pre-loved economies popping up everywhere and a great way of being able to afford high quality items at a fraction of the price. So now that I've shared with you the five steps that I follow before heading to the shops, I'm going to share with you exactly what I purchased and why. Now, I also want to point out that I shopped at Age, and this video is not sponsored by Age, and absolutely nothing was gifted to me whatsoever. I never actually purchased from Age before, and I was pleasantly surprised by how beautiful their items are, their dresses in particular, and their color palette and how well made they are. And some of the items were expensive, but some of them I thought were actually really quite reasonable. So Age, if you're watching this, please don't go and put your prices up. I think that you've got a big fan here. All right, first up is this amazingly beautiful dress. It's long sleeve, so it's been great for the weather. It's really pretty. It matches my color palette. It's really well made. The buttons are secure and stitched on. It also comes with spare buttons just in case. And it's got beautiful details. Things like these buttons that just make it so much more special and pretty. Now, this is an incredibly versatile piece. It's incredibly feminine, matches my color palette. But you can dress this up and dress this down. It's not a tip that I put in my steps, but it's something I really recommend is buying pieces that are versatile, pieces that you can dress up and dress down. You can wear with some flat sandals, you can wear this with some stilettos. You go from like a really casual barbecue look to a glamorous lunchtime look in a beautiful restaurant with champagne and cocktails and lots of fun things like that. So I absolutely love this. Now I style this in different ways. I have a beautiful thick black patent belt, which I gather in to make it really nice and fitted and flowing. The sleeves are absolutely beautiful. They're really billowing sleeves, and you can also flip up the collar. You can button all the way up to the top, or you can leave it just floating open with a beautiful collection of necklaces. We actually have a dinner party this Saturday, Tom and I, at our house, and this is what I'm gonna be wearing, and I'm so incredibly excited. Also, it's a linen fabric, so it's really easy to wash. However, I have to say, I had to take this to dry cleaners because last time I wore it, I had no idea, but I had food all over me. It wasn't until the next morning I was like, oh gosh, that's a bit embarrassing. And whenever I have worn this on social media, I always get inundated with so many messages from you guys going, where did you get that dress from? It came from Age. Now, the second dress that I bought from Age was actually a dress to replace two dresses from my wardrobe. I discovered I had a black dress and a white dress that had started to get really threadbare. One of them had actually really faded, and they were just looking really tired and tatty. So I decided to replace them with one really good quality dress, and it is this one. It is so pretty. It's really tight and gathered around here. It's got these beautiful ties up here. And in fact, I was playing around with this and you can tie it at the sides for a totally different look. So again, a really versatile dress that you can dress up and dress down. I wore these to the Van Gogh Art Gallery exhibition, which was like an installation exhibition, which I loved. And I wore this with flats walking around. It was just perfect. And then I wore it to lunch with my girlfriends. And it was really nice because it breathes, it's linen, it's so comfortable, it's so flattering around here, great around the bust line and the neckline and the décolletage. I absolutely love it. And again, you can play around with straps and style it in different ways. And also, you can pop the straps in and make it strapless. So again, a really versatile piece. You can style in different ways. I can wear it with a wedge, I can belt it, I can wear it with a big hat like I did at the Van Gogh exhibition. I love this. And it comes in a couple of different colors. It comes in white. Tempted to buy the white, but I'm going to exercise self-control because I've hit my budget. And that is when you hit that filled but not full limit. It's a really beautiful place to be in the retail shopping world. All right, the third item I bought from Age was a classic. I actually bought a couple of classics. And that is a simple white shirt. But this one is actually that simple. It's got beautiful detailings. I love how Age have got these amazing buttons that are really feminine but quite quirky as well. A classic shirt, it's very minimalist because it's actually symmetrical, one side slightly different to the other. But this is something I have already worn so much. It's a versatile piece. I can wear it with denim skirt. I can wear it with my jeans. I can wear it with a leather pencil skirt for work. I can roll the sleeves up. I can flip the collar up. I can wear this down to the beach with a bikini underneath. This has just been a fantastic investment. And this one was actually on sale. I'm really happy with this. The fourth item I bought from Age, and again, this is not sponsored by Age or gifted in any way whatsoever, is this top. I actually loved the beige, bony, tan color dress so much. I had to get this as well. And again, another item of mine I've worn so much, and this is, I guess, one of the downsides of being a minimalist, is your items do wear out. So this was a replacement for this, but a really pretty, same principles, really versatile. I can tuck the straps in, make it strapless. I can put the bows around the sides of the shoulders to give it another look, or just wear it normally like this. I've been wearing it with jeans. I wore it with a skirt the other day, like a tanned linen skirt. It was really pretty. It's a really soft feminine piece, a linen fabric, which is breathable. It can go in the washing machine. This is absolutely fantastic. I'm so happy with this. And again, this is another top that you would have seen in my YouTube videos that I get asked so many questions. Was that a top or a dress? And where did you get it from? So here's your answer, Age. All right, so the fifth and sixth items are coming up right now. This is a beautiful pink blouse. Again, this has been a really versatile piece. I wear it with jeans. I wear it with my black leather pants. I wear it with my skirts. I wear it with my shorts. It's a really pretty top. It's incredibly feminine. It breathes really nicely because it's starting to get a little bit muggy after having this like freakishly cold phase. And again, I can put it in the washing machine. It washes well, it wears well. And it's a really nice pink. I think Age have really perfected their color palette this season. They've got the right saturation. They've got the right shades. Like, I am so impressed by everything in the store. I could have gone nuts, but I exercised self-control because I knew my total budget I could spend. So absolutely loving this. The details, like, this is the thing is taking, I really admire the creativity and the workmanship that goes into pieces these days. Things like looking at these sleeves and how they sit. It's not just a basic cut sleeve. It's something unique and special about it, which for me is really important because I wear a lot of very simple, basic clothing. So when I find something that's got something quirky or something slightly different, I really love that because it does add a special touch to my wardrobe. And then finally, this was another sale piece you'll be very proud of, a classic again. I am living in shirts a lot because you can wear a bikini on underneath it, or I can wear it with my jeans if I'm doing this cool pickup. I can tuck it in with some denim shorts, or even with what I'm wearing a work skirt this morning. Really classic piece, really timeless. Again, it's a classic shirt, but again, it's got that Age touch to it with cool little quirky buttons. I can style it in different ways. I can flip the collar up. I can roll the sleeves up like I previously did. I can tuck it all the way in, or just the front, or just have it all hanging out, as I said, with a bikini over underneath, a sarong, and off I go down to the beach, or I can wear it to the office for a client meeting. Really good quality, versatile pieces. The stitching is impeccable. And even look at the detailing here. it's got two folds here. So taking a really classic, but adding some personal, tweaky, creative, clever touches that really transforms it. So you don't feel plain and dull and boring, you know, if you're a minimalist like me and like to keep it nice and simple. All right, as a reminder for everyone, as we approach Black Friday and Cyber Monday, shop responsibly, shop mindfully, and only buy what you love, value, use, and appreciate. And if you don't spend up to your full budget, make sure you put that leftover money to good use, like one of your financial goals, such as the $1,000 project. All right, everyone, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And of course, make sure that notification bell is switched on. You're following me on Sugar Mama TV, my Instagram account, and of course, my normal everyday Instagram account at Canisess. All right, everyone, ciao for now.